Hello, welcome to Accounting Hub. I'm Professor George Scarpin, PhD in accounting, and our topic today is bonds payable. And our video is about bonds payable according to International Accounting Standards, or our IFRS. So when we are talking about bonds, we have two bonds, premium and discount bonds. Fair value of a bond changes when market interest change. Market value of a fixed rate investment moves in the opposite direction of the market rates of interest. For instance, if the bond interest rate is greater than the market rate, we sold it at premium. We are paying more than the market, so we are giving them a premium. On the other hand, when the bond interest rate is lower than market rate, we sell them at discount. The market rate is 10, the bond interest rate is 9. We have 1% discount. Okay? And let's go to our Excel file. It's easier to find it. And if you are a regular here, you already know that. If you're not, I want to let you know that all our Excel files, they are free, and the link to download it is in our video description. And this video is focused on how to account bonds payable, not to find the numbers, the present value, future value, and so on. If you have questions about it, we have another video about bonds where we talk about this calculations here, and this video is also in our video description. So, what do we have here? First one, a bonds with discount. So, fair value of the bonds or face value of the bonds is £300,000. The bond rate is 5, market rate is 6, and we pay our and this bond rate here is per semester. So 5% per semester, market rate is 6% per semester, and the period is 6 semesters. Okay? And with these numbers here, the market value of this bond is £285,000. How do we account it when we issue the bonds? We issue them. Market value 285, so our cash 285, bonds payable 285. And what we have here, we will pay this interest after each semester, and we will pay the face value at the end of the 6th semester. So how do we pay it? We pay it based on bond rate, and our interest expense is based on the market interest rate. So how do we account it after each semester? Our cash is our cash interest. Our interest expense is our interest expense. This journal entry, it is not balanced, so we need to balance it. Debit less credit. So the number to balance it, we record it as bonds payable. So here, a bonds payable here. And this bonds payable, this amortization is the same of this amortization here. And we credit because we need a credit to balance this journal entry. So the remaining semesters will also be a credit. So we do the same journal entry after each semester. At the maturity date, we pay our bond. We pay how much? We pay the face value. So, bonds payable and cash. And here, if we go to our T account, after we pay it, we have it closed. And what if we have premium? Premium here, instead of, let's change these rates here. Let's consider market rates 6 per semester. Let me open paste these ones. And let me move this bonds payable. I am in front of it. Better. And let's consider now that our market rate is instead of 6, and by the way, if we have the same 6% here, we will have no premium or discount because the face value is the same as the carrying value. So let's consider now the market rate is 8%, or sorry, the market rate is 4%. So our bond rate is greater than our market rate. So now my cash will be 331, my bonds payable 331. So here, our bonds payable is greater than our face value. So the amortization of our premium should be a debit here to decrease this number. On the other hand, discount market value is lower than the face value, so that's why we credit here to increase until we achieve the face value. Here is our amortization schedule. And after each semester, the same cash is the cash interest, 18. Interest expense, 13. So we need now a debit to balance this journal entry. And the number is the credit less the debit. So 4,700 pounds. So here, bonds payable, this one. That matches the first premium amortizing. So the remaining ones will be here. Let's copy and paste. And now we are amortizing the premium. So the ending balance is the face value. And we need to pay it. So bonds payable, 300. And cash. The same 300. And here we pay it, so we close our T account. So we have no more balance on bonds payable. Okay, now it's better. Okay, guys, so oh no, that was pretty okay. So guys, please subscribe our channel. You will be the first one to know when a new video arrives. Also, like our Facebook page, Accounting Hub by Dr. Scarpin on Facebook. And thank you so much for watching this video. If you have questions or comments, leave it here or email me at jscarpin@gmail.com. Have a very nice day and God bless you.